Hey everybody, so I'm back to film my official Luxie hair extension review. This review has been a long time coming because I've had these extensions for almost 8 months now. I bought them in late September, but I didn't start wearing them till the beginning of 2013 because I didn't decide to grow out my hair till late December, and then I started playing with my extensions, dyeing them to the correct color, etc., etc. But still, I wanted to play with them for a good amount of months, a good amount of styling, washing, dyeing, and such before I release the official review. And I'm wearing them straight just so I can talk more about them rather than have them curled. I have worn them curled multiple times in my videos. If you haven't seen any of those videos, I will link some of them off down below as well as post pictures during this video. It is easier to blend extensions in when you're curling them and hide them, especially with the haircut that I am working with, because my natural hair is shorter on this side and longer on this side because I had an asymmetrical A-line bob. And as you can see, my hair is parted on this side of my head, so I also put less extensions on this side because there's less hair here anyway. It would look actually very weird if I had like less hair in my roots and very thick hair down here. So of course this side has more volume and more extensions. These are the first extensions that I have owned and worn personally, so I can't say I'm a extensions expert, but I can tell you about my personal experience with them. First and foremost, I did purchase these extensions with my own money in September of 2012 because I heard pretty good things about them. I mean, there are bad reviews on just about anything on YouTube, as well as good reviews. Luxie hair extensions, I feel like, because they are owned by a pair of YouTubers, the Luxie hair sisters, Mimi and Layla, I feel like there's a lot more attention on them because YouTubers, you know, are under the spotlight more so. But I'm here to give my completely honest, unbiased opinion on these hair extensions, because I did pay a good amount of money for them, and like I said, these are the ones I've been playing with lately. I have recently purchased another brand of extensions just to test out other ones, but that's not what we're here to talk about today. I'm sorry I keep touching my hair or the extensions. So Luxie hair extensions come in three options now. They only had two options when I purchased them last fall. And it depends on the weight of hair that you would like to buy. There is a 120 gram set for finer hair. That's the smallest gram set. And that retails for $130. And then there's the 160 gram set, which is the one I am wearing, which is for medium to thicker hair. And that retails for about $150. And they recently added an even thicker option, which is the 220 gram set, which is cray-cray, aimed towards very, very thick hair. The 220 gram set retails for $200. As far as the length of the extensions go, they are 20 inches long, and I do have a clip of me today before I put them on, and I measured them up to my scalp to show you guys how long it would fall if it was like literally like right up at the top of your head. And there's a lot of length to these. It's almost like abnormally long to me because my hair naturally has never been this long aside from when I was a baby. It never usually grows past like right here. So this extra, I don't know, 5 inches is crazy to me. I'm not wearing all of them right now. I never really wear all of the extensions at once just because I feel like I run out of room on my head, to be honest. I do, because I do space them out like with like half an inch in between each clip. I don't want to put too much in my hair because then my tender head starts to hurt. So I just wear enough that it looks okay to me. According to their website, their lifespan for the extensions can range from 3 months to a year. I mean, no one's going to come and make you throw your extensions away after a year. I'm sure you can make them last up to a year. It's depending on how you care for them, of course, how you wash them, condition them, how often you're styling them with heat and such. I do not wear mine that often, more so for filming purposes, so they still feel great and brand new to me, and I've only been using them for about 5 months, just, you know, sporadically, maybe like. The cool thing about Luxie hair extensions, I would say, is because they are owned by YouTubers, they do make YouTube videos that help you visually see how to care for your extensions, like how to wash your extensions, and they do a bunch of great hairstyling videos as well. So that was helpful. I mean, I was kind of scared to wash them at first, especially because I needed to dye my hair to the correct color because none of the shades available was close to my hair color whatsoever. And that's not their fault because my hair color is a little it's a little unique. It's a medium auburn with like purple undertones, but it appears really bright red in the sunlight, but a little bit more dark brown with a barely red tint inside. Like, it's very hard to capture that in a hair extension, so I understand completely why I had to dye them myself, and they are dyeable. So I just used my Garnier dye, which is listed down in the info box if you need the name, on my hair extensions. I didn't put them on my head to dye them. I just laid my extensions out on the table over some clear wrap on like a glass table, and then just like apply the dye to both sides. Hair extensions do match really well. I didn't dye all the way up to the clip because I was scared to damage the clip, so there's like an inch of the actual color of extensions. Let's see if I can show you guys. Yeah, there it is. As you can see, like, there's an inch of the actual shade because that's where the clip is, but then the bottom of it matches perfectly. So the next time I do dye them, whenever it does seem like it's starting to fade or something like that, I will dye probably higher up because I'm a little less, you know, paranoid about it now. I was just really scared of messing them up before even getting to use them. These extensions come in 11 different shades. I am wearing the only one that kind of has a red tint to it, which is the vibrant auburn shade, but like I said, I did dye them, so not exactly an accurate representation. It was way too light red, almost like ginger for me in my hair color, but it wasn't like an ugly hair color, it just wasn't mine. And these extensions are made out of Remy hair, which is supposedly the highest quality of human hair on the market according to the info box on their site. And the 160 gram set that I own comes with 10 pieces. So there's 4 1-inch wide pieces, 2 4-inch wide pieces, which have 2 clips on them, and then 2 6-inch wide pieces that have 3 clips on them each. And it comes with one of the huge, big 8-inch wide 4-clip extension, which I'm not wearing today. This is the biggest piece of the set. And then it comes with another 4-clip, but this is only 7 inches wide, so it is smaller. And these are the 2 largest pieces of the set, 1 of each. As far as their first wash goes, that was my fault that it was kind of bad and took a long time because I got them tangled. You should just take your time. Like, take a lot of time when you're washing your hair extensions and combing them out. And I like to dry them with a blow dry. You can leave them to air dry, but I like to dry them all done so they don't end up all jacked up. I don't know, I'm very scared of messing them up. So I blow dry them as well, and they were fine. Very minimum shedding. I mean, there is some shedding, but less than I would say you would expect, because someone with long hair like this would shed in the shower when washing their hair anyway. It's normal for people to shed. So the shedding wasn't really that much. It wasn't like I had a ball of hair. It was very minimal. It was like maybe like less than 20 strands out of all of the extensions, which is really good in my opinion. I was expecting a lot worse, but of course any shedding is kind of sad, but nothing so noticeable that I was upset about the quality of the extension. Luxie Hair advises you to wash your hair extensions about every 10 to 20 styles. I've washed them twice and I've probably used them about less than 10 times, but it's because one was after dyeing and one was after constant curling and stuff. I wanted to see how it would wash a second time as well, so I could review it for you guys and, you know, explain the shedding. And the shedding was not worse the second time. It was actually a lot less. It does frizz a little bit, but nothing to the point where I feel like it's not manageable. I just hit them with a little bit of a flat iron and they're pretty silky and smooth, and they still feel very nice and soft. It does feel very natural and real. It does look very natural and real to me, and others who have said it does blend well. It doesn't seem like it looks really fake, and I think that speaks for itself. So that is a good pro. The price, I don't know, I wouldn't say it's out of this world crazy. I think the price is pretty good as well. As far as cons go, I would say the shade selection can be an issue, but my biggest problem, I did have a problem that I think is very common for those who order with Luxie Hair, is that they do have a very strict return policy. So you should read the return policy and take caution when you are placing your order. Comes in a 2-part packaging that is clear, and I do have pictures so I can show you guys. The top has the pack of extensions in a little like hairnet thing to keep them from getting tangled. And there is a seal that says cannot be returned or exchanged if open. And it says it over the seal, so you will see it before you break it open to get to your extensions. Very, very obvious you shouldn't do that. That's why there's a second part has a little, like, tiny, like, 1-inch wide clip that is a tester strip, so you can test the color to your hair and the length to your hair and the thickness and such to your hair, and that's in the bottom section. So you can open the bottom section because it is the tester, but be careful with the pieces inside of the tester thing, because my clumsy self, I didn't realize that as I think I yanked the tester extension out, the cardboard backing also came with it, and then I misplaced it. So because I lost the cardboard backing to the tester, as you can see in the picture, it just looks clear, I cannot return my extensions. So I had to just work with what I had. And I didn't want to return, I wanted to exchange them for a darker brown color. I figured the darker brown would be easier to dye, because I dyed my natural hair when it was dark brown to my current hair color. So I figured I would just do that first. But it dyed perfectly fine, so no problems. No issues like that. But if you wanted to exchange it for a more urgent reason, you should be very cautious and very careful to read the return policy and to not lose any of the pieces inside, because it is a problem. They did tell me, like, because they want everyone to have a brand new set of extensions and I lost the cardboard backing, they cannot accept it, because then they can't resell it, because they can't just put another cardboard backing into it for some reason. So that kind of sucked. I was a little like, all the hairs there, don't you have extra cardboard backs? I mean, that's what I was thinking, but of course it's no problem, worked out in the end for me. As far as other Luxie hair reviews I've seen online, other people have had problems with shedding and quality. I'm not sure if I just have like a newer batch or if there's just different batches, but I didn't really have any problems with quality. I really do enjoy the quality of them, honestly and truly enjoy the quality, and I don't think the shedding is a problem, and I don't have a problem styling them or anything like that. I don't know if my standards are just lower or if my extensions were just up to par. Not exactly sure how that varies. Aside from just minor little things, like one of my clips had a white strand hanging out from it after their first wash. I mean, that I just snipped off. I think that was just, you know, because I was rough when I washed them, user error. And there's like, you know, little like sparse little pieces right here, but I mean, it's not like a problem, that little piece right there. I still can use them, wear them, and have no problem with it. Yeah, there's the white string, and this piece has a white string right here, which I think was from user error, to be honest. As far as giving my stamp of approval on trying these out, I would say they are worth a shot, but be very careful with the tester, and if you are unhappy with it, try to return them before obviously losing any pieces of it or doing anything to compromise your return or exchange. This is a little long, but there was, I guess, a lot of information to go about it, and I want to make sure that I give you guys a good representation of my experience with them. But hopefully you guys enjoyed hearing it all. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave them down below in the comments, and I will try to answer as many as I can. And I will see you guys in a later video.